All right. My question is kind of connected to the previous two. The comic or graphic novel world of like Warren Ellis is not one of compromise, if you could say so. Were there any big challenges in transferring that world to a mainstream-ish Hollywood film? And Warren, how much of a hand did you have in the process of the film?
But I think they were all worried when I told them I knew where they lived. No, right from the start I said, it's got to be an adaptation, not a translation. A graphic novel and a film, these are two very different beasts, and nothing is served by trying to do a direct translation. And in any case, the book's only 66 minutes long, 66 pages long. You try filming 66 pages, that's 30 minutes if you put a dance in the middle. So I always knew it had to be expanded. I always knew it was going to be an adaptation, and you go in with the mindset not of, let me protect my baby. It's very much, you go have fun with this now. Go make the eye out of the way. You have fun with this, see what you make of it. And the screenwriters, I still think, did an astonishing job of the adaptation. It's wonderful. They've added many new characters. There are many new scenes, obviously. But everything they added speaks directly to the themes and the intent of the original book. They never, ever lose sight of that, even when they lighten the tone. So, as the original writer, I couldn't be happier.
All right, we only have time for about two more questions.
Guys, I'm just looking at the tagline again about still armed, still dangerous, still got it. At this point in your career, in your life, is there anything that still scares you?
I'm sorry.
Anything that still scares you? Anything that scares you?
That scares me?
No.
It's my favorite part of making movies. There are a lot of different parts of movie making that I take part in, and that is talking about a project prior to the time they turn the camera on, doing the work after the film's been made, and talking about it afterwards, and participating in marketing of it, and getting the word out there. My favorite part is the making of it. And I'm scared every day because I keep thinking that I'm good, like somebody's going to throw me the ball. And I'm going to go, oh God, oh wow, I just messed that up. And not fear so much as excitement, and not that thrill of you have to make something, you have to create something out of 115 typewritten pages and make it be human and lifelike, but. I think I'm much more afraid of making a mistake in raising my daughters than I would on any work that I do as an actor. It's a much higher scale of fear that I'm raising.
I'm always kind of frightened all the time, really, actually. I think my whole life is just sort of overcoming fear. First nights in the theatre was really scary. Right now I'm terrified of the rubbish in New York. Such a mountain of it. Where does it all go? That's a scary thought. I'm terrified of plastic, basically. Plastic packaging, that's what's scaring me right now. There's too much of it. Get rid of it. Sorry to be ecological.
No.
And Bruce, you mentioned your love for graphic novels and comics. Do you collect them yourself?
I'm sorry?
You mentioned loving graphic novels and comics. Do you collect them yourself?
I don't collect them, but I've done a couple movies that are based on them. And they all turn out to be really fun projects and fun to do. And there's just more character in it. There's just more stuff that's already there that you can go to. And something, and for the most part, you know, people would expect actors to, you got to fill in the blanks. And when the blanks are already, they're not blanks anymore, and there's specific story things and character things and things that you're upset about, and what is your beef in this film? What is my beef in this film? It's always a lot easier for me.
Thank you.
But I want to correct you. I am afraid of other things. I thought you were just talking about filmmaking. There's that kind of fear, but yeah, I'm afraid of a lot of other things in the world.